Hello, welcome to LA Young Adult Evangelism School. I hope that we have all been enjoying summit time throughout the week and really seeing what God desires in God's time schedule. Let's begin with prayer. Heavenly Father God, thank you so much for being with us all the time, whether we recognize it or not. I pray at this time you will give us the grace of laying down all of our thoughts, desires, plans, and motives, and really focusing on what God desires and needs for this age, and give us the spiritual strength to challenge towards that with according to your time schedule. Please imprint the covenant of Jesus Christ deep into our hearts and really allow the young adults to see their mission and their role as the platforms for the remnants, the church, and their fields. I pray that you will really strengthen the young adults and give us the faith and the unity and oneness that comes from the gospel. We love you, and we pray in the name of Jesus Christ to break down all of the forces of darkness within ourselves and our fields and our churches so that we may worship you and bring the light into this world. Please give Pastor Park, your speaker, a double portion of the Holy Spirit and the five powers so that we may be able to spread the gospel into all of the regions where the young adults are scattered. May we give all glory to the triune God, and in Jesus Christ's name we pray, amen. Let us sing hymn 364, Sweet Hour of Prayer, and I hope we can all enjoy the blessing of this sweet hour of prayer. Let us have another moment of prayer as we wait for Pastor Park to deliver us the message. Heavenly Father God, we thank you so much for giving us your word with your grace. We pray that you will fill us with the Holy Spirit so that we may understand your desires and your time schedule. Allow us the spiritual strength to really let go and die on the cross and be filled with Jesus Christ and be able to enjoy, wait, and challenge all within your time schedule and your absolute plan. Please open our spiritual eyes so that we may see our role as the spiritual doctors, the ambassadors, and the watchmen of this age, and allow us to see your mission for us to save the remnants, the make disciples of all nations, and save the 237 nations through healing and the summit. We give you all the glory, and we pray that you will fill Pastor Park with the filling of the Holy Spirit so that his words, the words that he speaks, may not be his own, and the words we receive may not be the ones that we desire, but it may all be your desire and your spirit that is touching and moving all of us. We pray all of this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us look at Genesis chapter 12, verses 1 through 3.
예, 세 절을 우리 한 목소리로 같이 읽도록 하겠습니다.
Let us read the three voices together with one voice.
시작.
Begin.
여호와께서 아브라함에게 이르시되 너는 너의 고향과 친척과 아버지의 집을 떠나 내가 네게 보여줄 땅으로 가라. 내가 너로 큰 민족을 이루고 네게 복을 주어 네 이름을 창대하게 하리니 너는 복이 될지라. 너를 축복하는 자에게는 내가 복을 내리고 너를 저주하는 자에게는 내가 저주하리니 땅의 모든 족속이 너로 말미암아 복을 얻을 것이니라 하신지라. 아멘. 오늘 아브라함을 통해서 섬밋의 축복 이것이요. 237 나라 살리는 5천 종족을 살리는 그 섬밋의 시작이라는 말씀을 같이 나누겠습니다.
Through Abraham, we will share the word entitled The Beginning of the Summit, the blessing of the summit that allows us to save the 237 nations and the 5,000 unreached people groups.
하나님께서 우리를 부르실 때 하나님이 우리를 끌고 가는 방향이 있습니다.
When God called us, there is a direction in which He is leading us.
그게 시대 시대마다 하나님은 온 세상 모든 족속 237 나라 5천 종족까지 복음이 증거되는 겁니다.
And in all ages, that is proclaiming the gospel of God to all nations, the 5,000 people groups and the 237 nations.
거기에 내가 있어야 돼요.
And that is where we must be.
거기에 내가 있지 않으면 어떻게 됩니까?
What happens if I am not there?
계속 고난이 옵니다.
I'm continuously in anguish.
그래서 내가 237 섬밋의 여정 속에 있어야 돼요.
That is why I must remain within the summit journey of the 237 nations.
오늘 창세기 12장 1절에 3절을 보니까 아브라함이 이 여정 속에 있기 전에는 굉장히 고난이 왔습니다.
In Genesis chapter 12 verse 1 through 3 before Abraham entered into this summit journey, he was in great suffering.
애굽으로 내려가기도 하고요.
And then he goes down to Egypt.
굉장히 이것은 힘들었죠.
That was very difficult.
그래서 언제 이 여정 속에 들어갔냐?
At what point did he go into this journey?
창세기 13장에 보면은 조카 롯과 딱 결단을 해요. 자기는 언약 속에 언약을 결정하는 그 순간입니다.
It was the moment in Genesis chapter 13 where he parts ways with Lot and he makes the decision for the covenant.
그때 하나님이 아브라함에게 동과 서와 남 동서 남북을 바라보라. 네가 바른 땅을 내가 네게 줄 것이다.
At that point, God tells Abraham to look to the west, the east, the south, and the north, and that every land you will step on, I've given to you.
여러분 이 속에 들어가 있어야 돼요.
You must remain within this.
237 나라를 살리는 그냥 아무나 못 살리냐? 섬밋이 돼야 살릴 수 있습니다.
You have to become the summit of the 237 nations because not anybody can save. You must go into the seat of the summit.
내가 그 여정, 그 프로그램 속에 들어가 있어야 돼요.
You must go into this journey, into this program.
이방인의 제사장 이드로가 이 속에 있었습니다.
The elder Jethro of the priest of the Gentile people was within this.
모세가 애굽을 통해서 237 나라 살리는 그 서밋 여정 속에 모세가 있었어요.
Moses was also in this summit journey that was able to save Egypt and the world.
요셉이 그랬고 모세의 어머니 요게벳이 그랬습니다.
Joseph was like this and Joseph's mother Jochebed was also like this.
성경의 모든 사람들은 하나님이 끌고 가는 그 여정 속에 있었던 사람입니다.
All of the people that were used in the Bible were people that God has led through this journey.
역대상 29장 10절에서 14절에 다윗의 성전이 그렇습니다.
And in 1 Chronicles 29 verse 10 through 14, this was David's temple.
그냥 성전이 아니에요.
It was not just a temple.
237 서밋의 여정에 있는 그 성전입니다.
It was a temple that was within the journey of the 237 summit.
이방인.
The Gentiles.
이방인을 살리는 그 성전.
A temple that had the court of the Gentiles to save the Gentiles.
기도의 뜰, 치유하는 그 성전.
The courtyard, it had the courtyard of prayer, which is the temple that would heal.
렘넌트들의 뜰, 서밋하는 그 성전.
And the courtyard for the remnants, it is a temple that did the summit.
그냥 성전이 아니에요.
It was not just a temple.
그냥 그 돌과 나무로 지었던 그건 그냥 껍데기예요.
Anything that you build with just sticks and with just trees and stones.
하나님이 원하시는 237 나라 치유하고 살리는 서밋하는 그 성전.
That's just a building. What God desires is a temple for you to do the 237 healing summit.
네 번째